Hello all, so welcome to KO Tutorials. So in this tutorial we are going to texture this chairs and table over here using V-Ray. So let's get started. So very first of all, go into rendering, render setup, and set this to V-Ray. Make it as full HD and force to side. So select the floor over here. Let's go into material. Let's take a V-Ray material over here, name it as floor, go into diffuse, bitmap, and let's take the floor texture, go inside, and let's give the tiling over here, and let's go into this and give a normal bump over here. And join this with the bump map. Go into this normal bump, bitmap, and this is a normal bump for this, and copy this. So now if you go into this and you can just check the render, you will definitely see some kind of roughness on top of it. This is due to the normal bump. Now, so we are going to texture now this sofa part over here. So let's go into the material over here. Let's go into V-Ray material, diffuse, bitmap, and we have a red fabric material. So we are assigning this fabric material, go on top of it and give UVW map and set it as a box. After you have set this as a box over here, go into the material again and let's give again a normal bump and connect this to the bump map and into the normal bump bitmap, and that's normal map for fabric, and copy this and let's see the rendering. So you will see the roughness on top of it. So same thing we are going to assign on top of this also, the same over here, and again give a UVW map and just set it as a box. So go to the floor texture over here and we can give a bit of reflection to it if it requires. Select this wooden part, go into material. You can just rename this as fabric. Go down, again take one more V-Ray material, bitmap, and let's give a wooden texture and give a bit of reflection to it. Modifier, give a UVW map on top of it. So once you have assigned this UVW map, it's going to fit that particular texture on top of it. Same, define it as wood over here, UVW map, set it as a box over here and click OK. So now what I'll be doing is definitely it's going to be the same texture. So now I'm going to delete this part delete this stuff, select this whole thing and just mirror it, copy it in y-axis and duplicate it this way. So press shift and rotate it over here and mirror it in x-axis. That's it. So select this table, and if you want to give any other material to it, like a glass material, we can make it more darker, give a bit of reflection and give a bit of refraction to it, and go into this and increase its IOR to 2.55. click OK. So if you're required to put some basic V-ray lights, we can just put one basic V-ray light over here just to show. We are not doing any kind of a lighting over here, but just showing it. So just give a bit of a light, yellowish light. Multiplier, give it as 2 over here. Options, double sided, invisible, decay, and put one more light on the other side over here. Cast shadow off that. So we can just render and see how it looks like. Make this intensity as 1. So let's go into rendering and can just check out how it looks. So we've not done any kind of other settings over here for now. So I'll quickly do some settings over here. I'll go into the render setup. I'll do some settings. I'll make this as adaptive subdivisions. Keep it as Michelle. Go into color mapping, exponential, GI. I'll activate this GI light caching, the bounce. Better, and let's render it and see how it looks like now. Okay, looks much better. So if you want to go with the GI environment, you can add this GI environment in the scene. So can go in, press 8, go into rendering environment, and if you set any image in the background for it, or if you just set a sky image in the background, just set any can set up a sky image in the background. So I'll just save as it, and this, if we can go into this environmental map, bitmap, and can take this sky image and you can just render it, and you will see that you will get those reflections of the sky on the objects. Also you can use HDRI for that. Can go into this rendering, render setup. You also activated this GI. You can add a bitmap over here also, and you can just render that in the environmental map. So as you can see that you will get those reflections on top of this objects. So just let it render. So you're just, we're not using any kind of lights. We just used two basic V-Ray lights. You're not done a very proper lighting. You just used two V-Ray lights and done just some basic settings over here. And let's see. So it's going to take a bit of time for this. So definitely if we're increasing the settings over here, so you're not increase the noise, or we're not reduce the noise value over here. So this is just for your understanding. We have put an environment in the background. Definitely there will be walls, and if you have a light coming from a window or something. So definitely I'll be coming up with one more interior in the coming sessions, with proper texture and light, a detailed interior. So as you can see over here, it's taking a bit of time, but definitely we'll see the results. So if you can generate some passes, but for that you need to do a proper lighting. It's just for your understanding what we are doing over here. So as you see that, you will definitely see the roughness on the floor. That is just because of the normal bump. That's a normal map. Alright, so you're almost done, and it's going to final image. That's your final pre-pass over here. Alright, so it's taking a bit of time because of the high resolution of the render settings over here. So we have set it to HD, so definitely it's going to take time. So if you have any doubts, please write it in the comment section. I'll definitely come up. And please like and subscribe my YouTube channel, that's KO Tutorials, and stay tuned with it. All right. So we have generated this, that's of a glass over here. That's of a glass over here, as you can see over here. Oops, it's taking a very long time because of its render settings. So you can also give some reflection to the wood also. If you require it, you can give some reflection to the wood also. All right. So that's your final pre-pass, 4 of 4. So once it's done, it will just render that particular image now. All right. All right. So I've just used those V-Ray lights over here. All right. So it's going to render it in this way. So as you see over here, if you zoom it properly, and you will see that there is some kind of roughness on this. Can see the roughness? That's just because of your normal map. That's what we have generated. So you can increase the reflections if required for the floor also. Alright. So we have generated out its final output over here, as you can see. So it's done almost. That's it. So you can just save your file over here. That's it. So as you can see, just save your file in the sofa folder. All right. So thanks for watching this tutorial.